Hello and welcome back. This session will focus on factors affecting chromatographic behavior for HPLC. The following are the factors that may affect chromatographic behavior: pH of the mobile phase, concentration of salts in buffer, ratio of components in mobile phase, particle size, flow rate, injection volume, column temperature, and the stationary phase. So we are going to discuss each of these factors separately to establish how it affects the chromatographic behavior of the HPLC. What could be the impact of pH on the mobile phase? The mobile phase, pH has an impact on the retention time. However, we have some compounds that are neutral, so pH will have a little effect on their retention time. But we have those compounds that require pH to be monitored in order to stabilize the retention time. So when you're choosing a buffer or you're choosing the mobile phase, you need to choose a mobile phase that will give you a desired pH that can actually be able to stabilize the retention time. The pH of the aqueous buffer used in the preparation of the mobile phase can be adjusted to within plus or minus 0.2 units of the value. And this applies to both the gradient and isocratic separation. Concentration of salts in the buffer is one factor that could affect chromatographic behavior. Buffers are used to ensure reproducibility of retention times and reduce tailing of peaks. There are a number of buffers that we use within the lab while analyzing sample using the HPLC technique. For example, we have the acetate buffer, the phosphate buffers, borates, and even triethyl amine. So when you are choosing your buffer, it's necessary to consider a number of factors. One, the compatibility with the mobile phase. Choose a buffer that is compatible with the mobile phase, because if it is not, then it may form precipitates and this could damage the HPLC system. Then also consider the buffer concentration. Increasing buffer concentration leads to faster elution of the polar molecules. This can be used to resolve coeluting peaks, but higher concentrations will increase the viscosity, resulting in higher column back pressure. Then also consider the UV cutoff values. The buffer choice should be based on the transparency at the wavelength of detection. There are a number of precautions that are considered when using the buffer solutions. One, buffer support microorganism growth. So ensure that when you prepare your buffer solution, you give it a short expiry. Then ensure that you filter your mobile phase through a 0.45 or 0.22 micron filter. Then after using the buffer, flush the system with the same proportion of water, organic solvent ratio, followed by pure water and then storage solvents. This is to avoid salt deposits inside the HPLC system. Then the concentration of the salts used in the preparation of the aqueous buffer employed in the mobile phase can be adjusted to within plus or minus 10%. But ensure as we adjust this concentration of the buffers, the pH is within the permitted variation. So these adjustments applies to both the gradient and isocratic separations. Let's look at the ratio of components in the mobile phase. A mobile phase could have more than one component, but you're going to focus on how to adjust the composition of the mobile phase. So the adjustment of the composition of the mobile phase applies to the minor components of the mobile phase, specified at 50% or less. The amounts of these components can be adjusted by plus or minus 30%. However, the change in any component cannot exceed 10% of absolute value. So the 10% of absolute, that is the 10% of 100%, because 100% is the total composition of the mobile phase. So adjustment can be done to one minor component in a ternary mixture. Example of adjustments for binary and ternary mixtures are given below. So I've given some examples here that we need to work out and see how we can, how the adjustments has been done. So we need to maintain these adjustments so that we don't go beyond the required limits because this could also affect the pH, because as you're doing the adjustment, you need to put that into consideration. Another factor that could affect the chromatographic behavior is the particle size of the HPLC column. For isocratic separations, the particle size or length of the column may be modified, provided that the ratio of the column length to the particle size remains constant or within the range of -25% to 50% of the prescribed length to particle size ratio. Alternatively, other combinations of length to particle size can be used, provided that the number of theoretical plates is within -25% to 50% relative to prescribed column. So in particle size is not mentioned in the monograph, the ratio must be calculated using the largest particle size consigned in the USP definition of the column. For gradient separations, changes in length, column inner diameter, and particle size are not allowed. Flow rate is one of the factors that needs to be considered, and the principle is very clear. When you are looking at HPLC column with the same packing material but different particle sizes, then it is logical that when you have smaller particle size, you need a lot of pressure to move the solvent, the solution through. And if you have bigger particle sizes, the pressure will be less. So when you are changing the column, it's necessary to look at the particle size and adjust the flow rate appropriately. But as you adjust the flow rate, it's necessary to ensure that actually the column efficiency does not reduce by more than 20%. And in addition, the flow rate can be adjusted by plus or minus 50%, and this applies to isocratic system only. The injection volume can be adjusted as far as it is consistent with accepted precision, linearity, and detection limits. Excessive injection volume can lead to unacceptable band broadening, causing a reduction in the theoretical plates and the resolution. So the adjustment of the injection volume applies to both gradient and isocratic separation. Let's look at the column temperature. This is one factor that has an impact on the chromatographic behavior. If the column temperature is not maintained, you realize that you're not able to achieve a retention time that are reproducible. So it's necessary that when you're using the HPLC, your column oven has a thermostat that can actually control the temperature. And the temperatures could be adjusted to plus or minus 10 degrees Celsius, and it applies to both the gradient and isocratic separations. Another factor to consider is the stationary phase. This is where the separation takes place. The stationary phase retains the components for various periods of time, depending on the chemistry of the components in the mixture. The more the component in a mixture is held up in the stationary phase, the longer it will take to come out from the end of the column. So it is necessary that when you are choosing a column, you choose a column with a stationary phase that will enable separation of various components in the mixture you are analyzing. Watch out for the next session, whose focus will be on system suitability parameters.